on 24th of February, His Excellency the President was in the north. He received a number of complaints from the Wananchi regarding mismanagement of the PDM program. His Excellency the President invited some of the complainants to State House Entebbe to give him more details about the situation which was seen to be threatening and derailing.
Out of the over 482 people arrested by the anti-corruption unit regarding misappropriation of the parish development funds, 261 are civil servants who have already appeared in court and interdicted. Over 200 civilians have also been charged, with 79 convicted. Brigadier General Henry Isoke, the head of the anti-corruption unit at State House, says this year alone, 36 suspects have appeared in court, whereby 20 are government officials.
The PDM Secretariat also required that circles be formed within a month, gave a communication in May, and by end of June, circles were supposed to be formed, and this made the whole process very difficult. As a result, district commercial officers and production officers gave town agents and LOCs only 3 days to mobilize people and form circles.
He was giving an overview report to members of the National Resistance Movement Parliamentary Caucus, who are currently attending a 10-day retreat at the National Leadership Institute in Chankwanzi. This was on their investigations in Acholi sub-region.
In light of these findings, we observed that generally the complaints were valid. And whereas these complaints were raised by the people of Acholi, as I said, they generally reflect the general PDM operations in the country and therefore merit an urgent intervention.
The misappropriation of PDM funds was recently unearthed by President Yoweri Museveni during his investment and wealth creation tour in Acholi region on the 24th of February this year. This report comes at the backdrop of complaints received by the president from the Wananchi he met at Kaunda grounds in Gulu on the mismanagement of the PDM funds in Acholi sub-region. Following the complaints, President Museveni directed Brigadier General Isoke to investigate all the allegations and bring all officials found to be culpable to book.